Welcome back to the channel. It's Ken, KDL Hotshot. I'm sorry I've been away for a little while, but I have good reason. I ended up in the hospital just over a week ago, a little over a week ago. I was dying. I was at home. I had the oil changed. What else did we bring the truck? Oh, new tires, yada, yada. And yeah, man, like a week ago, I started getting pain up here in like my gut area. And I waited. And after 5 days, I just couldn't take it anymore. And I thought I was dying. And so they went in, they did all these tests and everything. And the doctors were like, "Your gallbladder, you have gallstones. And we need to remove your gallbladder." And I was like, I don't have insurance because I'm poor. So they said it would be like $50,000 to do the surgery. And I was like, but they put me in a room. Like, seriously, we were on, the surgeon's coming, the surgical team comes in. And we talked for like 20 minutes, right? And finally, I was like, point blank, does it need to come out right now? And they were like, no. So I said, give me whatever you gotta give me and get me the heck out of here so I can go back to work. So they gave me all these like antibiotics, and hopefully the gallstones are gonna go away essentially. I know it's gonna have to be done one day, but hopefully it won't be for, I just said hopefully twice, but anyhow. Maybe a couple years, right? At least a couple years. So I'm just gonna watch what I eat from here on out, and but I've been on the road for a few days now. I'll show you the load. We're gonna start unloading. I am in Oklahoma. I've got a couple of things on the trailer right now. Some pretty cool stuff. I did pick up at the port in Houston yesterday. It is crazy there. I almost saw a fight because two truckers just, they were like, one guy was trying to get in, the other guy wouldn't let him, and they both just, boom. Traffic everywhere, and neither one of them would move, and they just stood there, they just sat there right at each other, right? And then I saw a guy hit one of the concrete barriers driving around because the corners and everything are so tight, smacked it with his wheel, boom, whole trailer shifts. Needless to say, like I said, it was pretty crazy over at the port, man. But yeah, we've got two drops three hours away is where we're at right now. So I'm gonna show you what's on the deck once we get rolling, but I've got some coffee brewing, and you know what time it is. It's burrito time. So yeah, throw that ump on the dash. Let's get the, whatever this thingy bobber is called, the GPS. I unplugged that because these ports work consistently all night, so I don't like the lights. And when the curtains are pulled in here, man, I have to cover up the light from my cooler. But once I do that, it's pitch black in here because, yeah, man, it was only like 39 degrees, so no heat, no nothing. Yeah, no heater, no nothing. And yeah, dead silent, pitch black. So we had a good sleep last night. The blanket keeps me nice and warm, so pretty happy about that. But yeah, guys, sorry about the delay in the videos here, but my health ended up in the hot. If I was gonna do the surgery, I was gonna bring this. I was gonna have someone bring this because I didn't have anything. I didn't know what to expect. And they're gonna be like, oh, you just really need to go boom, boom or something, you know, but it was bad. Anyhow, I was gonna bring this and put up a video of me in the hospital bed, like post-surgery, like, and put up a Patreon account and be like, please help, because I can't work for a month. So that's avoided. The pain has somewhat subsided, but for the last 4 days I've been sitting in this chair, it's been hurting, man. Like, my back hurts. When the original pain happened, it was like someone took an 8-inch steel pipe, right, shoved it right through my solar plex here, out my back, and then just left it there. And that's what it felt like for hours. Like I said, not hours, days. And I thought I was gonna die. Like, I could barely even walk. It hurt so much. So yeah, 2023, what a good year. We've only got 2 weeks left of this year. 2024 is gonna be amazing. I've got some things behind the scenes that I can't talk about, but we're gonna start showing you guys. But cross your fingers right now, because something is happening today that's gonna determine what happens in the next 3 months. So cross your fingers. All right, we'll see you on the road. They already got a forklift ready for me, so I gotta boogie and get this thing done. But this is what we got. And who's ready for a big surprise? And when I say big surprise, I'm actually not joking. Let's go get our bar. That's what I got. See, forklift driver's waiting for me. Big surprise on this side of the trailer. What do you see? What the what? Yes, sir. I've got 8-foot loading ramps. Bang. All right, let me get this thing unloaded. We'll discuss more. There's our loads. So this is nice. It was that building, but they got a parking space right off the highway, so you don't have to go down any of those small roads. So how about that? Yeah, looks like I might have to back up there, but I'm just gonna get unstrapped and untarped. But yeah, here are my new ramps, HD ramps. Boom, boom, 20 inches wide. They're also load levelers, right? So now I can extend my deck to here or whatever. So, haven't used them, but what are we, this is our third drop since I've been on the road. I left Monday, today's Thursday. All right, let's get this ready to go and we'll have more conversation. I was going to my house, I backed into the tree in the front yard, dented this, moved it forward, thought I was good. I backed my truck in, I crushed that fairing. So, yeah, it's been a rough couple, you know, hospital destroyed my truck and trailer. But even though the tarp looks like crap, like proper fold, I'm trying to experiment with. When you put the tarp on top of the smaller loads, you have to throw the sides and they come hanging all the way down the trailer, right? And then you have to pick it up and put it underneath. Tuck it, so try to lay it out, boom, on top of the load, open, and then I'll just be able to pull the sides down to where I want a bungee. Or at least that's how it's working out in my head. We'll see. Yeah, man. I don't have a load yet. There's a Love's like 15 minutes from here. I haven't showered since Monday morning. It's Thursday. So I'm gonna get cleaned up, locked up, get over that Love's, fill up with fuel twice, wink, wink. So I get 2 shower creds and we can start figuring out how to book a load and yeah, get some other things done. Hopefully get a shower. Morning. Oklahoma Steel and Wire, Medill, Oklahoma. Bunch of stuff here. I'm on a scale. I weigh 31,820 pounds. You know what? Now that I just got back in the truck because I saw the scale. So what is another 240? So yeah. I'm like almost 32,000 pounds, empty. So they gave me a little, I gotta do a dog leg here, right here. This looks correct, fuel tanks. I'm taking a load to California, y'all. So my Christmas, we'll be driving my truck, but you you gotta do what you gotta do, man. I lost two loads on Friday, y'all, and I was not in a very good mood. And sat back and thought about it. I'm just gonna have to embrace the suck right now, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't have a choice. I'm financially ruined. So I just have to keep working until I can get things to turn around. And that's all there is to it. I can't have any more home time. I'm just praying that this thing does not, no more mechanical errors happen for me, because it is just, the downtime has eaten me alive since I bought this truck, right? All right, he's loading up right now. That's wire, like, fencing. You know what? I think that's concrete mesh. You put that in, like, concrete subfloors or whatever, and it holds the concrete together. So, these are going. I have three separate tractor supplies in California. And the reason I looked at it, it's paying pretty good, right? It's $4,000. I'll be done Thursday morning, hopefully. But it's like a 1,400-mile trek to drop one, 29 miles to two, 140 to three, and then I'm done, right? So I was like, okay, I'll do this multi-drop load. They're all going to Tractor Supply, and we had a good experience with the Tractor Supply last time. So, yeah, that's what's going on. No tarps, strap and go. I just went out there, so we're going to be doing a whole lot of edge protectors. But, yeah, here it comes. It drops. There it goes. It drops it down. And it doesn't even need dunnage. They just kind of jam the forks into it. So he sets it down, and then watch what he does with the forklift. Drives up beside it. Oh, wait, he's gonna come to this side now. Can you see it sticking out of the, it's past the rub rail right now. It takes the forklift and then boom, and then pushes it over to right inside the rub rail. So not bad. And should have been pushing that one too. But this guy knows what he's doing, so I'm gonna shut up and let him do his thing. But yeah, I don't know how many we're gonna have of these total. This load's supposed to be 40,000 pounds. You need a whole lot of those to get to 40,000 pounds, so we'll see. So if it is 40,000 pounds and I weigh 32,000 pounds, we'll be like 72,000 pounds. And we've got, like I said, exactly 1,427 miles to our next stop. So, I will get there at 3:47 a.m. tomorrow. I won't get there. Yeah, man. But the good news is today, this morning, I actually feel okay. Like, my stomach, ever since that thing happened, I've been terribly uncomfortable. I have stomach and back and the entire time. And this morning, I actually feel okay. So I'm just hoping and praying that this stays and I just start getting a little bit better. And yeah, man, we have a nice, safe, smooth trip across the country. No weather issues in Arizona, hopefully not. Here it comes again. Yeah, okay, so he's putting more on, so he's gonna level it all out, even it, once he gets everything on. I hope it's all labeled like the trailers were. But all right, let's get this thing loaded, strapped down. We got a way out, and then we're on the road for a nice 3 days of driving. No stress, just driving. So yeah, once again, look at this. Drop one, green is drop two, yellow is drop three. Everything's got a tag on it. Just had my vitamin hit this morning. Woo! No, I take emergency and all my vitamins all at once. And,
ow.
Yeah. So, there we go. Don't want to lose that.
Job 1, 2, 3.
Load, strap, paperwork, out! Let's go. I was hoping it was just this one is gonna give me some wind resistance, but yeah. Done a pretty good job loading here. Tags. I gotta throw some straps. There's a bunch of trucks behind me, so I'm glad I arrived. So we're gonna get it strapped down. See you on the road. Look at, let's weigh ourselves. Look, 73,020 pounds. And then my extremely skinny fit butt. Boom, 240 pounds. Okay, strap, edge protectors. Strap, edge protectors. I put two on that tall one. One, two, these are low. Because that shape, it should be pretty wind, whatever it's called. Aerodynamic is what I'm going for. Yeah, 240 pounds, man. I just can't seem to get below that. Lock in, coffee ready. What could that be? What time is it? It is 9:53, so 2 hours of loading time. I got myself some pudding snacks, you know, because that was like $4 for 6 of them. But at the Loves and all that, it's like $4.50 for one. Even though it has whipped cream and Reese's in it. That's funny, I was just talking about being so fat. Oh boy. Ow. Zingers. Off. Taco sauce, sour cream, bing, bing, bing. Let's go to Cali. We're going to Cali. What's the California? I think it's Katy Perry. Oh, and check this out, guys. The hospital they're bringing me to is on Florida Avenue in California.